Good morning, brothers and sisters. What is today? Wednesday. It is November 9th, and we are celebrating today the feast of the dedication of St. John Lateran. And St. John Lateran in Rome is the Pope's Cathedral. It's the Cathedral of Rome. And so, friends, let us begin our morning prayer with the invitatory. Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will proclaim your praise. Come, let us worship Christ, the bridegroom of his church. Come, let us sing to the Lord and shout with joy to the rock who saves us. Let us approach him with praise and thanksgiving and sing joyful songs to the Lord. The Lord is God, the mighty God, the great King over all the gods. He holds in his hands the depths of the earth and the highest mountains as well. He made the sea, it belongs to him, the dry land too, for it was formed by his hands. Come then, let us bow down and worship, bending the knee before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are his people, the flock he shepherds. Today, listen to the voice of the Lord. Do not grow stubborn as your fathers did in the wilderness, when at Meribah and Massah they challenged me and provoked me, although they had seen all of my works. 40 years I endured that generation. I said, they are a people whose hearts go astray, and they do not know my ways. So I swore in my anger, they shall not enter into my rest. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Come, let us worship Christ, the bridegroom of his church. The church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord. She is his new creation by water and the word. From heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride. With his own love he bought her, and for her life he died. Elect from every nation, yet one o'er all the earth. Her charter of salvation, one Lord, one faith, one birth. One holy name she blesses, partakes one holy food. And to one hope she presses, with every grace endued. My house will be called a house of prayer. O God, you are my God, for you I long. For you my soul is thirsting. My body pines for you like a dry, weary land without water. So I gaze on you in the sanctuary to see your strength and your glory. For your love is better than life. My lips will speak your praise. So I will bless you all my life. In your name I will lift up my hands. My soul shall be filled as with a banquet. My mouth shall praise you with joy. On my bed I remember you. On you I muse through the night, for you have been my help. In the shadow of your wings I rejoice. My soul clings to you. Your right hand holds me fast. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. My house will be called a house of prayer. Blessed are you, O Lord, in your holy temple. Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Angels of the Lord, bless the Lord. You heavens, bless the Lord. All you waters above the heavens, bless the Lord. All you hosts of the Lord, bless the Lord. Sun and moon, bless the Lord. Stars of heaven, bless the Lord. Every shower and dew, bless the Lord. All you winds, bless the Lord. Fire and heat, bless the Lord. Cold and chill, bless the Lord. Dew and rain, bless the Lord. Frost and chill, bless the Lord. Ice and snow, bless the Lord. Nights and days, bless the Lord. Light and darkness, bless the Lord. Lightnings and clouds, bless the Lord. Let the earth bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Mountains and hills, bless the Lord. Everything growing from the earth, bless the Lord. You springs, bless the Lord. Seas and rivers, bless the Lord. You dolphins and all water creatures, bless the Lord. All you birds of the air, bless the Lord. All you beasts, wild and tame, bless the Lord. You sons of men, bless the Lord. O Israel, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Priests of the Lord, bless the Lord. Servants of the Lord, bless the Lord. Spirits and souls of the just, bless the Lord. Holy men of humble heart, bless the Lord. Hananiah, Azariah, Mishael, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Let us bless the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Let us praise and exalt him above all forever. Blessed are you, Lord, in the firmament of heaven, praiseworthy and glorious and exalted above all forever. Blessed are you, O Lord, in your holy temple. Praise the Lord in the assembly of his holy people. Sing a new song to the Lord, his praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel rejoice in its maker. Let Zion's sons exult in their king. Let them praise his name with dancing and make music with timbrel and harp. For the Lord takes delight in his people. He crowns the poor with salvation. Let the faithful rejoice in their glory, shout for joy and take their rest. Let the praise of God be on their lips and a two-edged sword in their hand, to deal out vengeance to the nations and punishment on all the peoples, to bind their kings in chains and their nobles in fetters of iron, to carry out the sentence preordained. This honor is for all his faithful. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Praise the Lord in the assembly of his holy people. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Them I will bring to my holy mountain and make joyful in my house of prayer. Their holocausts and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord is great beyond all telling. He exceeds all praise. The Lord is great beyond all telling. He exceeds all praise. In the city of our God and on his holy mountain, he exceeds all praise. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. The Lord is great beyond all telling. He exceeds all praise. Zacchaeus, hurry down, I mean to stay with you today. He hurried down and welcomed Christ with joy, for this day had come, for this day salvation had come to his house. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Zacchaeus, hurry down, I mean to stay with you today. He hurried down and welcomed Christ with joy, for this day salvation had come to his house. We are the living stones laid upon the cornerstone that is Christ. Let us pray to our all-powerful Father for his son's beloved church, professing our faith in her as we say, This is the house of God and the gate of heaven. Father, like the farmer, you prune your vineyard, protect it, and increase its yield until it extends before you throughout the world. This is the house of God and the gate of heaven. Eternal Shepherd, protect and increase your flock, that all the sheep may be gathered into one flock under your Son, the one Shepherd. This is the house of God and the gate of heaven. All-powerful Sower, plant the word in your field, that it may yield 100-fold for your eternal harvest. This is the house of God and the gate of heaven. Wise Builder, sanctify your home and your family, that the heavenly city, the New Jerusalem, your spouse, may appear before all as your glorious bride. This is the house of God and the gate of heaven. And for what else shall we pray for this morning? As we gather the prayers and the intentions we hold in our hearts, as we remember the people who have asked for our prayers, we lift up our voices, praying those sacred words that Jesus himself taught us, praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. God, our Father, from living stones, your chosen people, you built an eternal temple to your glory. Increase the spiritual gifts you have given your church, that your faithful people may continue to grow into the new and eternal Jerusalem. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord bless us, protect us from all evil, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And friends, thank you for joining me today this morning for morning prayer from the Liturgy of the Hours. How good it is for us joining together, praying this, the prayer of the church, praying with the church, through the church, indeed praying on behalf of the church and for all of her members. I just want to issue a quick I'm sorry. I was supposed to post a video yesterday, and that didn't happen. I meant to, but it just wasn't in the cards. And then I tried to post one on Sunday, and it worked on Facebook, but apparently my upload to YouTube did not work out. So, not sure what's going on, a little bit of a technology fail. So, apologies for that, but here I am, it's Wednesday, I'm back, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Let's remember to pray for one another throughout this day. So, friends, whether you are out and about today, whether you're staying in, remember to be safe today, to be healthy today, to be happy today, but above all, remember to be holy today, that you would live out the holiness of Jesus Christ today in your life. May God be praised in you. May God be praised through you. And friends, I do hope that you have a beautiful day today.